My name is Maya Elias. I am a PhD student and registered nurse at University of South Florida. I am also a research assistant in Dr. Borlongen's lab here at the Center of Excellence for Aging and Brain Repair, Department of Neurosurgery at the Morsani College of Medicine, University of South Florida. Here at the Center of Excellence for Aging and Brain Repair, I work closely with Dr. Borlongen and other researchers to look at the efficacy of stem cells in the therapeutics of stroke. Here in the laboratory, I'm able to really cultivate my interest and curiosity in science. I'm able to use the microscope. I'm able to use different chemicals. I'm able to look at different proteins and really take a look at all the aspects of science and research that I wouldn't be able to experience otherwise without experience in the laboratory setting. I'm actually the first person in my family to be born in the United States. Actually, I was born in Oklahoma City. My parents were born and raised in India. What was difficult for me in the past in getting to this point is that I am a first generation American citizen in my family, and I am the first generation to obtain a college degree and then a master's degree, and now I am a PhD student here. My original degree is in nursing, and I am a registered nurse. I did consider becoming a physician, but I decided that as a nurse, I was specifically interested in certain patient populations, such as the older adult population and the neurosciences. And that's what really focused my career path in research, because I can really take a look at the patient population I'm interested in and truly make a difference for those patients in the long term. So here we can see the microglial cells in the cortex.
Is there any other part in the brain that you can see those microglia?
Yes, it seems that we can also see this in the corpus callosum.
So what exactly are the microglia?
I hope to directly apply my research to patients in the clinical setting. I hope that what my research focuses on is beneficial to neuroscience patients and patients with neurodegenerative diseases. As a woman and as a minority and as a first generation college student and college graduate, I can safely say and confidently say that believing in yourself and being persistent and looking ahead and having a goal in mind always will lead you to success in the medical field.